Greetings, everyone. Once again, this is Elder R.L. Dunlap Jr. coming unto you with the only infallible, the only uncompromising, the only unadulterated written word of God. We greet you from God the Father and from His Son, Jesus Christ, who is alive and is now set on the right hand of the Father, according to the scripture. We greet you on today. Get your Bibles. You on YouTube, hear me? Get your Bibles. Get your Bible. Our video seems to be doing a little freezing up on YouTube, but get your Bibles. Get your Bibles. Yeah. Hallelujah. Thank all you for viewing. We need to deal with something on today. Have you ever heard the phrase used in church or used among us or among you? Have you ever heard anybody say this phrase or these phrases? They said, "You see my glory, but you don't know my story. You see my glory, but you don't know my story." Watch this. Some say, "Well, I don't say my glory, I say the glory." You see the glory, but you don't know my story. Same thing. And some say, "I was built for this, honey. I'm built for this. I'm built for this." I'm built for this. You don't know what it took for me to get this anointing. You don't know what it took for me to get this anointing. All of those fleshly sayings. You're pointing people to you. You see the glory, but you don't know my story. I'm built for this. You don't know what it took to get the anointing. You don't know what it took. All right, let's show you the error of your way where you'll stop saying stuff like that. Okay? And most of you that saying that, Pastor William, most that say that, you right, it's their glory, all right, because they definitely is not preaching and teaching and operating in the word of God and walking in the spirit. Walking in the spirit, don't put themselves on parade. Who is you? Let's go here. Get your Bible. Go to what I want. What do I want? Corinthians. I think that's what I want. Is it Corinthians 1? Is it Corinthians 1? And I got to move quick. I got to do one more. I got to do one more post after this. Maybe in about an hour I'm going to do another post, because this evening is on about 4 o'clock, 4:30. I got to go to the prison system to be recertified and go through orientation and be recertified to continue to work in the prisons. So go to Corinthians chapter 1. You want to be wonders. You self-proclaimed wonders. You, some nicknamed themselves the sons of thunder. Where you come from? The sons of thunder. I know. I'm not new to it. I'm true to it. I know about Pastor E.W. Wilcox, Bible Day Revival Church. I know about Bishop E.E. Cleveland. I know about them. Yeah, the Sons of Thunder. The Boy Wonder Preacher. I went to a church one time. I was invited. And this certain preacher, he came out of the pulpit to introduce himself. This be a good thing. This be a good lesson too. When you go to introduce yourself to other people, you don't introduce yourself as no title. You don't introduce yourself as that. My name is Robert Dunlap. You know, my name, many call me, my name is it. Okay, my name is Dunlap. A title ain't about nothing. You know. But this preacher came out of the pulpit. My name is, sir, watch it. He said, they call me the Holy Ghost man. They call me the Holy Ghost man. That's what they call me. Hey, that's not even important what they call you. They call me the Holy Ghost man. Putting all these topics and titles up. You see my glory, but you don't know the story. I was built for this. I built for this. You don't know what it, you that, watch this. Watch you putting folks down. You know, they put folks down. Yeah, I'm exposing you. They put folks down. They let you know you ain't on their level. They let you know that. They say, you coveting folks anointing. You coveting other folks anointing. Watch it. You coveting other folks anointing. You don't know what it took to get that anointing. Look at them putting folks down. You coveted other folks' anointing. You don't know what it takes to get their anointing. Oh. You do know that Apostle Paul said, covet the best gifts. Have you forgot that? All right, where you taught that? Covet the best gifts. But rather that you prophesy. They putting you down. Y'all coveting somebody else anointing, but you don't know what it took for them to get that. Look at him putting you down. You don't qualify to walk in anointing. Okay, let's get this straight. You see the glory, but you don't know my story. My story. My story. I was built for this. I was built for this. I was built for this. Go to Corinthians, the first chapter. Corinthians first chapter. There, I got it. This part of holiness too. You lifted up in pride. Go to Corinthians 1. Woo! Go to Corinthians 1. Kind of warm. I just got out of the shower, so I get. Corinthians 1. And let's look at this. Let's look at the 9th verse. Let's see what your story is. Let's see why you was anointed. Let's see what you went through to get your anointing. Let's see what it took to get your anointing. Corinthians, the first chapter, 1 Corinthians 1, read with us. And 9, 1 Corinthians 1 and 9. This part of holiness. 1 Corinthians 1 and 9. God is faithful. God is faithful. By whom? By whom? Not by your doing. Not by your qualification, because you unqualified. God is faithful. For by whom? Is by him. Were ye were called into the fellowship of his son Jesus Christ our Lord. God did it. Wherever you are, whatever your gift, God gave it to you. You didn't earn it. You did not earn it. God gave it to you. You didn't earn it. God gave it to you. I said God gave it to you. Slap your neighbor high five and say God gave it to you. You didn't earn it. Ooh. You can pray all you want to. You can fast every day if you want to. You can lay up under the altar if you want to. You can sit at every apostle's feet if you want to. And you can be a flocky for every bishop carrying his briefcase if you want to. And wipe the sweat off his face. And hold the microphone cord. You can pray all you want to and fast all you want to. You can fast every day if you want to. That ain't getting you no gift or no anointing from God. I know, I know, I know. I just messed up some of you old saints. I know. Your fasting and prayer did not get you your anointing from God. That did not get it for you. That didn't get you your anointing. That didn't get you your gift. Nothing you did got you your gift. Let go over here. I got to hurry up and get out of here. What do I want? What do I want? 12? Corinthians 12? Let's see. Let's see here. Corinthians 12. And Corinthians 12, 8. How you get your anointing? How you get your gift? How you walk in your calling? How you walk in apostolic? I walk in apostolic. What is it? I got the apostolic anointing. I got the prophetic anointing. None of those words is in the Bible. Are you an apostle? Are you a prophet? Okay. How did you get your anointing? 1 Corinthians 1, 8. For to one is given by the Spirit. By the Spirit. Not by you. Not by your fasting. Not by your praying. But by the Spirit. Not who your daddy is or who your daddy was. I don't care if your daddy was bishop and your mama was a missionary. That did not get you your anointing. I don't care if you fasted 40 days and night. I don't care if your husband left you and whooped you all upside your head. That didn't get you your anointing. Oh, I'm not new to it. I'm true to it. That didn't get your anointing. I lay before God and fasted 30 days. And the Lord came spoke to me. I'm not saying he did, but that didn't get you your anointing. You fasted 40 days, didn't get you your anointing. For one is given by the Spirit, the word of wisdom, by the Spirit. And what got you your anointing? By the Spirit. Go down and let him verdict. But all these worketh that one and self same Spirit divinely every man as he will. He will, not you will. He will, not you. He, not you. He. That's all you want to. As he will. You can want to be a prophet all you want to. That's not going to get you there. You can pray to be a Lord, I want to be a prophet. You can fast for it. Don't eat nothing. Don't drink nothing. Don't have no sex with your wife and with your husband. Don't look at TV. Don't look at radio. Don't read newspaper. Don't drink or eat nothing. Get in psychology and lay out before God. I mean, lay out before Him. Don't eat nothing so long until you're so weak that you can't even get up off the floor. You're just that weak. That ain't giving you your anointing. God give. It's God's glory. It's God's doing it, not yours. All right, go back here. Go back here. We better start. Well, let's start with 3. 1 Corinthians 3:1. And I, brethren, could not speak to you as spiritual, but as carnal. You carnal. You point to yourself, you're carnal. You're not spiritual. I don't care how you walk around with your eyes closed, looking like you deep, with your eyes closed. I went to a meeting one time, it was a woman came in with a cyclaw, a cyclaw, a Kroger sack roll. Made out of burlap. A roll. Look, you carnal. Point to yourself, you carnal. Point to yourself, you're carnal. I couldn't speak to you as spiritual, but as carnal. Carnal. Even as unto babe. I fed you with milk and not with meat, for hitherto you ain't able to bathe. Neither yet are you not able. You still calm. For ye are yet calm. For whereas there is among you every strife, division, are ye not calm? You calm. And walk as men. While what? He will prove you calm. He will prove you calm. While one said, I'm a Paul. Another, I'm of Apollos. Are ye not carnal? Who is Paul? If you ain't carnal, hear what you were saying. Who is Paul? And who is Apollos? But ministers by whom ye believe, even as the Lord gave to every man. The Lord gave to every man. If you're a minister, God made you a minister. God made you a minister. If you're a minister, God did it. You didn't do it. God did it. All your fasting and praying didn't do it. God did. Watch it. I have planted. Apollos water. But God gave the increase. Look at it pointing back to God. God gave the increase. Come on. So then neither if he had planted anything, neither he that watered anything. What did Paul say? The one that Apollos and me, what did he say? Neither is he that watered anything. We ain't nothing. Apollos ain't nothing. I'm not nothing either. But God give the increase. It's about God, not about us. One verse say, we preach Christ and not ourselves. Let me see. Let me see here. Let me. Let me, I thought I had this scripture before. I know where it says, but I want to show you where it's at. You understand? I know what it says, but I want to show you so you can read. Go to, and we're going to be through. Here we go. Here we are. 1 Corinthians 15:10. Go to 1 Corinthians 15:10. 1 Corinthians 15:10. Read. You're pointing to yourself. You don't know my story. Yo, watch it. Your story is dawn. Your story is as dawn, Apostle Paul said. Your story, Paul said, I got all y'all beat at first story. But I counted all as dawn. 1 Corinthians 15:10. By the grace of God, I am what I am by the grace of God. And his grace was bestowed upon me was not in vain. God made me who I am, and it was not in vain, for I'm going to operate and abide in my calling and do that which pleases God. Watch it. But I labored more abundantly than they all. Yet not I. I did more work than all of them that spoke. Yet not I. Look at what he said. Yet not I, but the grace of God which was with me. It's God's grace. It's God's grace. You are what you are. It's God's grace. You know, I've been on YouTube now probably about going on 5 years. And a lot of messages that I have, I believe they said I have 580 videos on YouTube. On one channel. I have 2 channels. Now, a lot of messages that I preach and put on YouTube, I pretty much forgotten about it. I don't go on and go through all my messages. I rarely do that. But I get alerts. If someone comment on it, I get an alert. And I got an alert last night on a message that I preached on YouTube entitled, Why Do a Lot of Preachers, they preach against the law and everything in the law except for tithing? Why do they keep that? How come they don't say that's the law and preach against that? And I did put that video on YouTube. And a gentleman contacted me yesterday, this morning. He said, I've been waiting for someone to finally come and tell the truth concerning that. And I thank you for doing it. And he said, brother, you have more wisdom than most preachers I know. You know, okay, hold it. To God be the glory. It's God glory. It's God glory. It's not mine. It's God glory. It's God. It's God. It's God made me who I am. It's God placed me in the body of Christ. It's God made me a teacher. Not me. It's God glory. Give God that glory. Stop taking God glory. You thief, you. I'm built for this. I was made for this. I was made for this. No, you were made to go to hell. Because you were made in sin and shaped in iniquity. You see my story. My story. My, you get it? My, you see my story. You see my glory. My glory. My glory. You see my glory. My glory, but you don't know my story. Like your story got you your glory. It's God's glory. It's God's glory, not your God's glory. And your story did not get it to you. God himself decided to give you whatever and place you in whatever position in the body that he chose to. He chose it. You didn't. and you did the same. It's him. If he hadn't told you, you wouldn't be in it. That's enough. God bless you. God keep my prayer. I'm going to come back probably in about an hour and do the other message that I had planned. Anyway, thank y'all for viewing. God bless you.